My name is Jens Redeman. I'm the principal investigator for the Aerosols project, and I work for the NASA Ames Research Center in Moffett Field, California. The Aerosols missions is a five-year project in which we're going to fly two research aircraft in 2016 and one research aircraft in 2017 and 18 each from Namibia to study the interaction of biomass burning emissions and low-level clouds over the Southeast Atlantic. There's a long list of reasons why we're working here in Namibia. The ER2 aircraft that you see behind me actually requires a very long runway and a large hangar so that the instruments can be opened up and properly maintained after each one of their flights. It's also the only access point to the Southeast Atlantic, really, from which we can fly and reach far into the Southeast Atlantic Basin. So we're studying a very unique system. The low-level cumulus clouds are not unique to the Southeast Atlantic, but the fact that they're coexisting with biomass burning emissions at altitude is very unique to the Southeast Atlantic and gives us the opportunity to study the interactions of aerosol particles with these clouds. These interactions actually are some of the largest remaining uncertainties in how humans affect climate. We think that the data is useful in two ways. First off, there are really no observations of these aerosol particles in the Southeast Atlantic because they usually overlay these very bright clouds. And the satellite information that we gather don't quite give us all the details that we need in order to study their effects. The other thing is that these effects and interactions between aerosol particles and cloud particles really go on globally. And climate modelers struggle mightily with parameterizing them and putting them into their global climate models. So implicitly, we hope to have an impact on the predictions of future anthropogenic impacts on climate. Namibia has been most welcoming. We have been welcomed with open arms. The infrastructure is terrific. The airport has been recently renovated and gives us perfect infrastructure, really. But it's really the welcoming by the university and research types in the country that has made this a little bit special. We're very excited to be here. Pulling off a research effort halfway around the world is always difficult. And we've finally been able to do it with a lot of support from Namibian government entities and a lot of local researchers and support. And we couldn't be more excited to be here.